has almost given you indication that you had to really put a real emphasis on getting the word in you. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's not just something, just a haphazard thing that you have to kind of give consent. I mean, you have to have a very strong focus of whatever you might be believing for of the word, in the overall the word of God, the word. Like I say, spending time and study it. Because you look through it, that's seems like to me that's basically what it reference to. You know, because it's reference to the word of God being sown. Mm-hmm. And, of course, some favor, like I said, some favor wayside, some favor stolen ground.
Right.
So that means that tells you that you had to put a genuine interest, you had to spend time with it. Mm-hmm. I mean, you had to be the focus of your life, mm-hmm. and you really had to study it out. Mm-hmm. Because if not, then the elements would deter you from what you believe in or what you might be having confidence in to get you to start thinking another way than what the word is saying.
Mm-hmm. Right.
So it just seems like to me it's just not just something that you can really just take lightly. You know, if he said what he said, mm-hmm. then you need to look at the both the ins and the outs of it, mm-hmm. and study it out with why he said what he said. Mm-hmm. I mean, you know, and really give it, you know, a strong thought about it and really study it out in the truth. That way it'll firm up your belief, mm-hmm. once you know, you got your confidence that, well, God said this. Mm-hmm. Hey, well, he said then I believe it. And you can't that way. Mm-hmm. The different things or the elements that might be going on, you know, deter you from what you mm-hmm. believe.
It's so easy to steal it.
Right.
Once that seed is planted, it can easily get stolen as quickly as you receive it. It can easily get stolen away.
Okay, Brother Wayne, Brother Williams was saying it's easily get stolen. Now, Brother Wayne probably at a level now that I feel that he has, you know, all these years he's been here, he's at a different level now. His belief has gone way up. But I think that probably results from some life experience that he had. He had to employ the word, and the word had to become reality. Otherwise, he probably wouldn't have survived what he was dealing with. So that goes back to show you a life experience, if you can come through it. But the ability to come through is that you got to deal and focus with that word. But he came through it, mm-hmm. and as a result, he just have a different mindset. Mm-hmm.
But do you think that it's, I believe, is hindering us from getting what God wants us to be at because we try to help him?
Okay.
You know, we get in the way. We get in God's way more than we believe. But we'll believe a thing is going to happen, and we'll say, okay, it's going to happen. And after a while, when it don't happen, we try to help.
Okay. All right.
You know, it's human nature to try, you know, to do these things.
We try to do it in the flesh.
Just being a human being causes us to block a lot of our gifts from God.
Right.
Yeah. So I think if we would just believe and stay out of God's way, mm-hmm. and just continue to believe, you know, wholeheartedly on His word, and I think a lot more things would.
Right.
Kick in.
Abraham and what's
her name?
Sarah.
Sarah.
What's
all right.
The maid's name?
Yeah. Okay. Now, y'all remember? I think in this section, or maybe the next handout that we have, is that for how many years was that? 25 years. The promise that God had spoken to Abraham and Sarah. It was delayed. It seemed like nothing they could do to bring that promise to pass, because God had promised Abraham that he would raise up a seed from the womb of who? Sarah. Okay. Now, anybody remember what God had to do to elevate his belief in order to get that promise to pass? What did God have to change about him? Anybody can remember?
His name.
All right, Sister Sheridan.
Woo!
All right, now, what was the significance of changing his name? Anybody can tell me?
He heard people repeat his name over and over, and his is what his name meant.
All right, the name meant, look, I am the Father.
Amen. All of those years, he wasn't what? He wasn't agreeing with God in his what? Confession. Then God said, the only way I can get this man to come in agreement with this promise, to bring this promise to pass, I'm going to have to what? Change his name to Abraham. So Abraham's name was changed from what? From Abram to Abraham. That means I am the father of what? Many nations. All right, so Sarai's name had to be changed from Sarai to what? Sarah, which meant I'm the father, I'm the mother of many. Every time her name was spoken or she spoke it, I'm the mother of many. Even before she was mother of any. She was the mother of what? Many. So that shows that that word had to what? Get ingrained. It had to make life on the inside. And that's the thing that Brother Wayne was saying, that you're really going to have to get more involved. And let me just tell you this. I remember when I was praying for a particular case. This was a case that it was very, very difficult. This was a problem that had been had this person in bondage for many, many, many years. And it took me 21 days before I could break through and really take the victory and break that power that had held that person in bondage. I was fasting and praying. Why couldn't I have done that on the first day? The first day. Not that I didn't know the word, and I probably knew as many scriptures then that I know now, probably more. Okay, but something had to happen to the word that I knew. God had to what? Stir that anointing and put an anointing on that word and put some life on that word, so that that word, Jesus said that the words that I speak are spirit and what? Life. Until your words are spirit and life. And fasting really helps you to, just like Brother Rudy was saying, to get out of the flesh and trying to make it happen your way. I mean, you lay aside all of the props and all of the, just like Abraham, he had tried a whole lot of stuff to try to bring God's promise to pass. What did he try? He tried all of his what? His maids? Having babies by? So, but when God took away all of the what? All of the fleshly methods and this and that, Abraham had to stand on the word of God, and he had to work with that word until that word produced the life that could bring that promise to pass. And that's the thing, that the quickest way I have found to really get in the realm where spiritual things become reality is that really through just kind of getting away, reflecting on the word, but fasting really, really helps. Why do you think that all of these great men of God that did all of these exploits and supernatural things, what were they men that were able to fast 40 days? Elijah, Moses, Daniel, 21 days. He was in mourning, but he lived a fasted life. So I think that one thing that we have drifted away from is that we probably, I think that we can all get back to it now with all these, because we got some good water that will help us. Well, the water has high antioxidant components, and it brings your body into balance. Like, you're not going to get as hungry as you used to get. If all those antioxidants, which are 100 times higher than the best fruit and vegetable, you ought to be strong after 7 days of drinking the water only. So we got some help. Y'all don't act excited about it. All right. I think that fasting and prayer, the reason why the spirit of the body of Christ has really diminished and the anointing, the interest in souls and spiritual things and prayer is because, just like the parable of the sower that Brother Wayne, y'all read that, Mark 4, that's the reason why we're in the condition that we are, because it's the cares of life, the busyness, and the demands, you know, that all of us are subjected to, and we just don't have the time, and because we don't have the time to focus on it, our consecration has really taken a big blow. And I think a good prayer would be to pray the consecration prayer in your book there. That kind of gets you back into the spirit of it. But I was thinking, y'all can pray about this. I was thinking maybe October we could kind of revive that consecration thing. Everybody going to sleep over? Boy, I long to see the saints break and weep and cry and repent and turn to God with all their heart. Be everybody you see crying out to God with all their heart. Everybody want to what? Lay aside every weight. That's what I'm praying for. How many will follow me? I mean, I'm not going to put no big burden on you, but if y'all could just kind of work with me a little bit, show up maybe once or twice here and there, stay 3 hours. Let's move on, Brother Al. Okay, well, I just thought I would just kind of share some of those things tonight, and I think the month of October, y'all tell me, how could we do? Now, I appreciate those that come on Sunday morning at 9. That's really good. And Monday night, it's been a good night. Monday night has been good. And we getting some breakthroughs, and Brother Travis kind of been hampered a little bit. And he has had two brothers that kind of helped him. You still showing up, aren't you?
Yes, sir,
Pastor. All right, so we're going to make prayer warriors out of all these brothers. Is that all right, brother?
I'm
God. Yeah, man. Let's call October our breakthrough month. I believe if we can get broken through in the spirit, I think that we'll get broken through and we'll get a breakthrough in finance. I believe God will bless everything that we put our hands to. How many believe that? God wants to bless everything that we put our hands to. All right, y'all continue to read. I want you to read about the three components of meditation: verbalization, internalization, and what else did I say? And visualization. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's in that same handout. Just master that. And all of this is leading towards something that will become really real to you once we get our breakthrough in prayer next month. I think the breakthrough has already begun in the morning time. Oh boy, I tell you, we got a few ladies that's really spearheading this thing, and it's going to break out after a while. Okay, let's all stand.